Hello, it's Angus here at the Bureau of Meteorology. Today is Sunday, the 24th of December. Yes, it is Christmas Eve, but we are in the middle of a thunderstorm outbreak across the eastern states with severe thunderstorms through the course of the day today, the 24th, and tomorrow, Christmas Day, the 25th of December. Let's start off by checking out the current situation regarding storms through primarily New South Wales at the moment, but there are a couple of storms through Brisbane and southeastern Queensland as well. This is the radar imagery from this morning, and we can see a number of areas of yellow and red showing heavy rain, showing thunderstorms and severe storms. In particular, this cell here moving towards Brisbane has been generating some heavy rain, and in the past 24 hours we've seen other thunderstorm cells in this part of the country here generating some very large hail, up to 10 centimetres in some cases, and that just shows the potential in the atmosphere at the moment for generating these large storms. And with no big shifts in the weather pattern, we hold on to that potential for the next couple of days. Let's check out the current severe weather warnings associated with these storm cells at the moment. This is just a snapshot, but we do have a severe thunderstorm warning for that cell approaching Brisbane from the west, likely to move through in the next hour or so, and a broader severe thunderstorm warning through some inland parts of northeastern New South Wales, down about as far south as Port Macquarie. This is just a snapshot at the middle of the day on Sunday, and this will change. Severe thunderstorms are dynamic and evolving weather events. They will change, new ones will develop, and they will move, and we will update and add to our warnings accordingly. So wherever you are through the course of this afternoon and Christmas Day, do check the latest warnings, because these will be out of date soon enough. We will have new warnings issued as the new cells do develop. Let's check out what might change over the course of the rest of Sunday. We anticipate further storms with possible severe storms through this area here, southeastern Queensland, eastern New South Wales, but also developing around Victoria, Sunday evening, Sunday night, particularly in the west of the state. And it's getting dragged down to the south because of a developing low pressure center here, which will become a little bit more obvious as we move the map to Monday, Christmas Day. We'll see this low start to spin up somewhere near the Vic New South Wales border, dragging that moisture southwards, and we end up with this hook shape all the way along the Queensland coast, the New South Wales coast, and down around into Victoria, where heavy showers and possible thunderstorms are expected through Christmas Day, especially through the afternoon. That means there's a chance of thunder and maybe even a severe storm through Brisbane, Sydney, Canberra and Melbourne, all of those capitals seeing a risk on Christmas Day of thundery weather, and could be some damaging wind, could be some large hail as well. In terms of rainfall accumulations over the next couple of days, this is the 24th and 25th together on the same map, just giving an idea of some of the top totals we might see out of these storms. Now, thunderstorms always give very spotty rainfall totals. That's one of their characteristics. It's not consistent widespread rain, but some areas that happen to see the most severe storms will get some pretty intense rainfall. Could see areas touching 80 to 100 millimetres over the next couple of days, basically all the way from the centre of Queensland all the way down to Victoria. Could be a very wet day for Melbourne, Brisbane and Canberra in particular. Sydney, the chance of a storm, might be some brighter weather through parts of Sydney. The other capitals on Christmas Day, one or two showers possible for Hobart and Adelaide, but certainly avoiding the worst of it in those places, and a lot drier and a lot warmer through central and western parts of the country. So this is a time of year for relaxation and celebration, but it is certainly worth keeping half an eye on the weather and half an eye on those severe thunderstorm warnings through Christmas Eve and Christmas Day. Could be some major weather events around eastern parts of the country, and if you've travelled to a new part of the country for Christmas, it's a good idea to know where to find the warnings that are now relevant to where you are. So you can always get the latest info at the Bureau website and on the Bomb Weather app, and we'll keep you updated on social media as well.